Over the last century, the world has spent over $2 trillion on dams. In China alone, since 1949, there's been an average of more than one dam built a day. Let's look at some of the economic issues. One obvious plus of dams is simply that they provide a lot of power. In China, for instance, dams account for about one-fifth of the nation's stationary power supply. Even better, this power is green in the sense of not releasing a lot of greenhouse gases into the atmosphere. Dams bring the political plus of being a kind of trophy achievement, so a government can show quite visibly that it's trying to do something for the people. Of course, this can also be considered a minus. There's a tendency in dam expenditures to have a lot of cost overruns, high levels of corruption, and often poor planning. Dams symbolize the achievements of regimes, but they also symbolize their failings and their corruptions. Dams also tend to bring some fairly negative consequences. For instance, dams require the relocation of many people in order to build the dam. In China, over 23 million people have had to relocate their homes, and they've typically been completely uprooted, often without serious compensation. Dams, especially large dams, also tend to have negative environmental consequences. This can range from endangered species to damaging local wetlands to disrupting entire ecosystems. The combination of the environmental issues with the dislocations also mean that dams very much divert or change or destroy parts of a region's cultural heritage. In the future, the Yangtze River in China will not have the same mystique and cultural importance that it has had in times past, and this is largely because of the dams which have been built there. Many dams cross national boundaries, and this can result in what's called an externalities problem. For instance, the Mekong River runs through China, and it also runs through much of Southeast Asia. When China puts a dam on the Mekong River, this alters the flow to the downstream nations. Of course, what's good for China is not always good for those same downstream nations. There is always an attempt to negotiate a dam internationally when it crosses national borders, but these attempts do not always succeed. In some cases, the upstream nation simply does more or less what it wants, and the downstream nations have to suffer. Overall, a lot of the world is moving away from the idea of dams as large development projects. The World Bank touted them and financed them in the 1960s and 1970s, but with the rise of the environmental movement, there's now much more skepticism about dams in a lot of quarters. Dams remain extremely popular in China and India, and also China as an exporter of dams, most of all to Africa. For some sources on dams, read these and, of course, use Google.